Hello 8th class, good morning to everyone. In our previous class, we were doing exercise 9.1, that is addition and subtraction of algebraic expression. Today we are going to continue with that. We will be starting with part 2 of question number 3. We have to add the following, and the terms are, sorry, expressions are first, second, and third one is this. Okay, we will write first term, first expression, then we will move on to next expression and we will put right like term below like terms. Okay, so b we will put here, it has plus sign, then minus c, we don't have like term for minus c, so we would be putting it here, then plus bc, we don't have like term for bc, we will be writing it separately but in the same row. Next we will move on to third expression, that is c we will be writing here with a positive sign. Minus a, like term is a, we will be writing minus a below a. Then plus ac, there is no like term to ac, so we will be writing it on the side. Now we are going to add them, okay? Addition, ac is single, so we will write it as it is. Similarly, bc. Now minus c plus c, they will cancel out and we will get 0. Then plus ab is single. Then minus b and plus b, they will again cancel out, we will get 0s. And similarly a, 0. Okay? So we are left with ab, where answer is ab plus bc plus ca or ac. ca and ac are the same thing. Okay? Next we are going to do one more part, that is part 4. Of question number 3. In part 4 the terms are l square plus m square, m square plus n square. Third expression is n square plus l square, and fourth expression is 2lm plus 2mn plus 2nl. Okay, we will start with first expression, l square plus m square. Now we will pick next one, m square. We will put m square here plus n square because there is no like term to m square. Then next expression, this one, m square plus l square, it will be, We will be writing a new expression in the next row. Okay, so plus l square, we will write it here. Okay, no, l square will be written here because we have like term to l square. Then 2lm, next row 2lm, there is no like term to 2lm. So, we will be writing them on the side, 2 and L, okay? Now, we are going to write, okay, column wise, 2 and L plus 2 and N plus 2 LM with a positive sign, N square, and coefficient here it is 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, okay? Similarly, M square, we will write the variable first. As it is, then we will write, we will add the coefficient 1 plus 1 again 2. Similarly for L square, we will write the variable part and add the coefficient. So, this is going to be our answer. Okay? Next is question number 4, A part. We have to subtract 4a minus 7ab plus 3b plus 12 from which expression? 12a minus 9ab plus 5b minus 3. Okay? I'll be again repeating the method for subtraction. We will write the expression after from word. First, we will write this expression. Then we are going to subtract the expression like written before from this one. Okay? But we will be writing like term by like term. Okay? Like term below like term. First is 4a. So 4a will be written here. Minus 7ab. AB. Okay? Minus 7ab. Then plus 3b. Okay? B is here. So plus 3b. Plus 12. Plus 12. So okay? We have written the both expression. Now we have to subtract. Subtract means the all the signs of below written expression will get changed. So here it was positive, it will become negative. It was negative, it will become positive. It was positive, negative and negative. Okay? Now we can start from left hand side or right hand side. The answer will remain same. Suppose we are starting from right hand side. Okay? Minus 12 minus 3. It is going to be minus 15. If signs are same, we add the numbers and put the common sign. Then next is B. We will write the variable as it is. B is the variable. We wrote the variable. Then we perform calculation on our coefficients. 5, it has become negative, so minus 3. Okay? 5 minus 3 is going to be b, 2 plus 2. Okay? Next, we will write the variable as it is, ab. Now we perform the calculation on coefficients. It is minus 9 plus 7. It is going to be minus 2. How? If one number is positive and one number is negative, what we do? We subtract the smaller number from bigger number, but keep the sign of bigger number. So it is going to be minus 2. Next we reach on to A and the coefficient is 12 minus 4. 12 minus 4 will be 8. So this is going to be your answer. Okay. Next we are going to do B part. In B part, we have to subtract 3xy plus 5yz minus 7zx from 5xy minus 2yz minus 2zx plus 10xyz. Okay? As discussed earlier, the expression written after from will be written first. Okay? This expression will be written first. 5xy minus 2yz minus 2zx plus 10xyz. We wrote the expression as it is. Now we will move on to the first expression and we will write this expression by writing like term below like term. Now first is 3xy, xy, here it is xy, so we will be writing it below this term. Next is 5yz, yz is here, so we will write it 5yz. Next is 7zx, zx is there, so minus 7zx. Now our expression is complete. Now we want to subtract this. It means the all the signs of below written expression will get changed. So it will become negative. It will become negative and it will become positive. We will start doing calculation from the right hand side. It is 10xyz plus. Now we will write the variables that is zx as it is. Now coefficient part minus 2 plus 7. We will subtract smaller from bigger, that is 5, and keep the sign of bigger number, that is plus 5. Yz minus 2, minus 5, minus 7, x, y, and coefficient is 5 minus 3, that is 2. So this is going to be your answer. Okay, last part is C. In C part, we have to subtract 4p square q minus 3pq plus 5pq square minus 8p plus 7q minus 10. From which expression? 18 minus 3p minus 11q plus 5pq minus 2pq square and plus 5p square q. As discussed earlier, we will be writing the expression after from. Okay? After from, this is the expression, we will be writing this expression as it is. So we will get 18 minus 3p minus 11q plus 5pq minus 2pq square plus 5p square q. Okay? Alright, now we are going to write the first expression, this one, term by term, by writing like term below like term. Okay? First term is 4p square q. P square q. Where is p square q? It is p square q. Okay? So we'll write 4p square q. Okay? With sign positive. Next term is minus 3pq. Where is pq? Okay? PQ is here, so we'll write this term here, minus 3PQ, okay? Next term is this, 5PQ square, PQ square, PQ square is this, okay? So we'll write this term here. Next is minus 8P, minus 8P, P is here, so minus 8P. Then next term is 7q. 7q is will be written here. And then minus 10. Minus 10 will be written here. Okay? Now we have written the expression. And we want to subtract. It means the sign of below written expression will get changed. It will become positive, positive, negative, positive, negative, negative. Okay? We are going to start from right this time. Okay? 18 plus 10. It is not negative anymore. It has become positive. Okay? 18 plus 10 is going to be 28. Okay? Now, we will write the variable. It is P. Then minus 3 plus 8. Okay? It is going to be plus 5. So, plus 5. Then variable as it is minus 11. Minus 7. It is going to be minus 18. Then we will write the variable as it is. Plus 5 plus 3. It is going to be 8. Then next is PQ square. Minus 2 minus 5. It is minus 7. Then P square Q variable as it is. Coefficient 5 minus 4. It is going to be 1. Okay? So this is your answer. With this, we have completed exercise 9.1. Next, we are going to learn how to multiply monomials. We are going to start with multiplication of two monomials. Okay? Monomials mean one term. Okay? Algebraic expressions having one term. Alright. Now suppose the expressions are 5ab and you have to multiply with minus 7a square b. Okay. So product of monomial, product of expressions will be equal to product of coefficients. Okay, so here it means we have to find out 5 into minus 7. Okay, multiply with product of algebraic factors. Okay, so algebraic factors here is a b and here it is a square b. All right, so it is going to be minus 35 and it is going to be a into a square into b into b. It is going to be minus 35 a to the power 1 into a to the power 2. It is going to be a to the power 3, because when variables are multiplied, when numbers are multiplied, their powers got added, and here it will be equal to b into b, b square. Or you can remove the product signs to write your answer as minus 35 b a cube b square. This is going to be your answer. We are going to do question number 1, 9.2 exercise. A part. We have to multiply, find the product of the following pair of monomials. First is 4 and 7p. Second is minus 4p, 7p. Okay? Here, required product will be equal to product of coefficients, that is 4 into 7 into product of algebraic factors. Okay, algebraic factor we have only p. Okay, so we'll write p. 4 sevens are 2p, or we can ignore, we can remove this multiplication sign. So this is going to be your answer. Here your required product will be equal to product of coefficients, that is minus 4 into 7. Okay, in coefficients, if you remember, we take signs with the number. Okay, so you have to take sign also in consideration. You have to take right minus 4 instead of only 4. Okay, now product of algebraic factors, it is going to be p into p. All right, it will be minus 28 into p is going to be p square, or we can remove the product sign to get answer minus 28 p square. Next, third part is you have to find out product of minus 4p and 7p cube. Okay, again same rule, and the rule is you have to find the product of coefficients, multiply with product of algebraic factors. Here it is p and here it is p cube. It will be minus 28, multiply with p into p is p square and q as it is, or you can write say minus 28 p square q. Next one is minus 3p and 4p cube. So your product will be product of coefficients, that is 4 into minus 3, and product of algebraic factors, that is p cube into p. It is going to be 12 into p to the power 3 plus 1. It is going to be 4 minus 12p to the power 4. Next question is, you have to find the area of rectangle. Okay, we have fifth part also. Fifth part, you have to find product of 4p into 0. So your required product will be product of coefficients into product of algebraic factors. It is 0 and 0 into p is 0. So this is going to be your answer. Now question number 2. Pair of monomials are given. Suppose first part is P and Q. Okay? So product area of rectangle. This is length. Okay? It means length is P. Breadth is Q. Okay? So area of rectangle will be length into breadth, which will be equal to P into Q, or you can say PQ. We will do one more part, last part, and in that pair is 3mm and 4mp. Okay, it means this one is your length and this one is your breadth. Required area of rectangle will be L into B, which will be 3mm into 4mp. Product of these monomials will be product of coefficients into product of algebraic factors. 4 is a 12 into m into n into n. We will club the same variables together. So it will be 12 into m into n square and p. This is going to be your answer. Question number 3 is, again we are given two monomials, you have to find the product. Now we will do question number 4. Question number 4, first part, in this we are given three monomials, and monomials are these. We have to obtain the volume of rectangular boxes with the following length, breadth and height. Okay? This is your length, this is your breadth and this is your height. Okay? The volume of rectangular box will be equal to L into B into H. So it will be equal to 5A into 3A square into 7A to the power 4. Now what we will do? We will find the product of first two monomials. Okay? Whatever will be the result, we will multiply that with the third monomial to get our answer. So it is going to be 5 is a product of coefficients into a square and multiply with 7a4. It is going to be 5 is a 15 a to the power 3 into 7a4, or again we are going to find product of these two monomials. 15 into 7 into A3 into A to the power 4. It is going to be 7 5 is 35 3 105, A to the power 3 plus 4. It is going to be 7. So this is going to be the volume of rectangular box if length is this, breadth is this and height is this. Next we will do third part of question number 4. In third part, length is xy, breadth is 2x square y and height is 2xy square. So volume of rectangular box will be L into B into H, which will be xy into 2x square y into 2x y square. As decided, we will find this product first. So it is going to be 1. 1 is the coefficient here and 2 is here. So 1 into 2. Okay? Multiply with product of variables, product of algebraic factors. X into y into x square y. Okay? We will write it as it is, into 2x y square. It is going to be 2x. We will club x squares together. So it is x into, okay, we will write again. X into x square into y, okay? We rearranged the factors and we got this. It is 2x to the power 3, y to the power 2 into this term. It is this. Again, we will find the product of coefficient, which is going to be 4. Then product of algebraic factors, which is going to be this. Now we will club the same variables and we will get 4 into x to the power 3 into x, y to the power 2 into y to the power 2, which is going to be 4 x to the power 4 and into y to the power 4, or we can simply write 4 x to the power 4, y to the power 4, and this is going to be our answer, that is volume of this, these given dimensions. Now question number 5, we are given 3 monomers, you have to find their product. Question number 5, part A is x, y, y, z and z s. Okay? So we have to find out the product, and product will be x, y into y, z into z s. Okay? In all three monomers, the coefficient is 1. It means 1 into 1 into 1, it is going to be 1 only. Then product of algebraic factors, x, y, y, z, z, x, which is already written. What we will do, we will rearrange the variables. Okay? X into y into y. Y into y. Then z into z. Okay? It means we are getting x square, y square and z square as answer. Now we will do second part. In second part, the monomials are a minus a square and a cube. Product will be product of coefficients. Here it is 1, here it is minus 1, here it is 1. 1 into minus 1 into 1. Okay? Into here. A into a square into a cube. It will be minus 1 and it is going to be a to the power 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is minus a to the power 6. This is going to be our answer. Next part 3 is 2, 4y, 8y square and 16y cube. 16y cube. We have to find the product of these 4 monomials. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So product will be equal to product of coefficients, that is 2 into 4 into 8 into 16, multiplied with product of algebraic factors, that is y into y square into y cube. Okay? It is going to be 4 to the 8, 8, 8 is a 64 into 16. It is going to be y to the power 1 plus 2 plus 3. 1 plus 2 plus 3. Because when numbers, variables are multiplied, their powers got added. Same variables. ठीक है, नॉट डिफरेंट. सेम वेरिएबल्स आर मल्टीप्लाइड, देयर पावर्स गॉट एडेड, इट इज गोइंग टू बी दिस मच. ठीक है, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू मल्टीप्लाई ए मोनोमियल विद ए पॉलीनोमियल. ठीक है, वी विल जस्ट लर्न द मैथड एंड देन कंक्लूड अवर क्लास. मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ मोनोमियल विद ए पॉलीनोमियल. पॉलीनोमियल मीन्स टू और मोर देन टू टर्म्स. ठीक है, पॉलीनोमियल इज टू और मोर देन टर्म्स. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड इट विद वन एग्जाम्पल. सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू डू, सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू मल्टीप्लाई 2x मल्टीप्लाई 2x विथ 3x प्लस 5xy. ठीक है, हाउ विल वी डू दैट? वी विल फर्स्ट राइट द मोनोमियल, मल्टीप्लाई साइन एंड देन राइट द पॉलीनोमियल इन टू द ब्रैकेट. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, द ब्रैकेट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आफ्टर राइटिंग द प्रोडक्ट व्हाट यू विल डू, वी विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस मोनोमियल विद दिस टर्म, यूज दिस साइन वट एवर दिस इज प्लस, हियर इट इज प्लस, इट मीन्स देन we will multiply this monomial with this. So it is going to be equal to 2x into this 3x. Then this sign plus 2x into then this term 5xy. Now this is converted to product of monomials and we know how to multiply two monomials. It is going to be product of coefficients, that is 3 to the 6, and product of algebraic factors, it is going to be x to the power 2 plus product of coefficients, that is 10, and product of algebraic factors, it is going to be 6x square plus 10x square y. Now we have reached at unlike terms and they will won't be added. Don't try to add them up again. Okay, some students will add them up again and will write 16x square y. That will be totally wrong. We will try one more example. In this we have to multiply a square with 2ab minus 5c. First step is you will write monomial, use the product sign and write your polynomial within bracket. I'm repeating again, use of bracket is very important. Next is multiply the monomial with first term of the polynomial, use this sign, then multiply the monomial with the second term of the expression. It is going to be a square into 2ab, then this sign is negative, a square into 5c. Okay, it is going to be product of coefficient. Now both are the monomials, 2a square into ab minus product of coefficient 5 into a square c. It is going to be 2a square plus into 1 into a. It is going to be a cube b minus 5 a square c, and this is our answer. With this question, we are concluding our class. We are going to meet tomorrow again. Have a nice day.